out that total energy is equal to how much? Total energy is equal to open electron, it is equal to minus kz e square upon 2r. We have also seen that radius of nth shell is equal to 0.529 n square upon z up angstrom, n square upon z angstrom. So what we are going to do, Mariam, here, okay, let others come down. So Myra is here. What we are going to do, Mariam, here is that we will put this R here and then we will derive what the energy of nth shell will be, okay? What will be the energy of nth shell? So Samira, we have just started. I've just written what we ended up with in the last class, that is the total energy and the radius of the nth shell, okay? Radius of the nth shell. Now, what I can do here is I can also find the energy of nth shell. If I put the radius, the value of radius from, and we can substitute the value of radius. So what will be the value of radius? It will be minus k z e square upon 2. Then you will have into 0.529 into n square. And you have in the denominator z. So that denominator z will go up and you will get into z square. Okay. Now what I want you to see all these things. See, all these things are constant, right? All these things are constant. Then what we can do is we can just write it something like that. There is some a big Q constant, a big constant Q into Z square upon N square. And that is why you can say that energy of nth orbital, sorry, energy of nth orbit is directly proportional to Z square upon N square. Okay, it is directly proportional to the charge. That means energy is directly proportional to Z square upon N square. So energy will be, now one more thing is that negative sign here. Now, if I change this Q, then I can get the energy value in different units. So if I talk in terms of electron volts, this will be minus 13.6 Z square upon N square electron volt per atom. If I talk about, this is to say, if I talk about joule per atom, it will be equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 Z square upon N square joules per atom. Similarly, if I want to talk about kilojoule per mole, energy of nth shell will be equal to minus 1312 Z square upon N square kilojoules per mole. So the most important one is this one. We'll do a few questions on this also. So please write this much, energy of nth shell, okay? Energy of nth shell. Okay. But there is one point here that it is negative, and we have already said that negative energy, it means that the force of attract, sorry, the force interacting, the force that is between nucleus and electron is attractive force, okay? The force is attractive. Write the same point here. You can say that the force of attraction, the force between nucleus and electron is attractive force. Is attractive force. The next one that I can write is, the next one that I can write is, okay, now you have to tell me, okay, you have to tell me two things. Mariam, you tell me, if the force of attraction is, if the force is attractive, if the force is attractive, then the value is negative. The value of energy is negative. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'm saying once more, if the force is attractive, then the value is negative. Now, if I compare between two things, okay, if I compare between two things, then I can say that more attractive will have more negative value, and less attractive will have less negative value.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
Very good. That means I can say that. That means I can say that we have this nucleus. The electron is, let us say, here. And it will have some kind of energy that is negative. Okay. Now, as it is negative, this is case A. And if you have electron here, which is case B, then I can obviously say that the energy of case B is greater than the energy of case A, because both of these values are in negative, right? So let us say, for example, in A case, we have negative 10 values. Obviously, in B, we will have less negative value, that is minus 5, to say. For example, we'll have minus 5 value. And obviously, minus 5 is greater than minus 10. Okay, minus 5 is greater than minus 10. Now, let us imagine what would happen. What would happen? This is one nucleus. And the electron is so far away, it is so far away that it is not feeling any attraction from the nucleus. It is so far away that it is not feeling any attraction from the nucleus. Now, if it was feeling some attraction, then it would be negative. If it is not feeling any attraction, it will be zero, because it cannot feel repulsion. If it feels repulsion, then only it will be positive, right? Now, when it is not feeling any attraction from the nucleus, that means the energy is zero. That means the energy is zero. Now, the energy between the positive proton and the negative electron, it can never be positive, correct? Because this is positive charge and negative charge. It can never be positive. So the highest energy, the maximum energy an electron can have is a zero. Is what? It is zero. So please write the next point. The maximum energy that an electron can have is zero. Okay, is zero. Now let us see that when will that zero become? When will that zero become? When the distance from nucleus and electron is infinite. That means if something is not under influence of something, for example, let us say can you see a city? It's not, if you cannot see that, then infinity is a relative term. Okay, infinity is a relative term. And when electron is not under the influence of nucleus, we say that electron is infinite distance away from the nucleus, because the nucleus is not even able to attract the negative charge. So that means that electron is present at infinite distance present at infinite distance. Okay, you have got the this values, right? So you have written this, the electron volt one. Please write these two points. This is important.
Yes.
Okay. Now, question. Calculate the energy of electron present in first orbit of hydrogen. Calculate this now. Calculate the energy of electron present in first orbit of hydrogen. So quite a simple question here, okay? So if you know the formula, you just have to plug in some values. Okay, Samira, you will tell me the energy of nth orbital is equal to minus 13.6 z square upon n square electron volts. Yes, Samira?
Yes, sir.
Now, in this formula, minus 13.6, what is the z here? Z is the atomic number. Oh, if you don't know that, please write this somewhere, okay? Z is equal to atomic number. And n is equal to shell number. So tell me,
it's one.
What will be the z? 1 square upon 1 6 square, 5. Right? Sorry?
Yes, sir, 1.
1 square, right? Electron volts. So the energy is equal to minus 13.6 electron volts. Easy?
Yes.
That means the nucleus is pulling. Please understand this. It means that nucleus is pulling the electron with 13.6 electron volts of force. The negative sign, it is only for attractive force. That means it is pulling. If something is pulling, that is why it is negative. But what magnitude it is applying, by what magnitude it is pulling, that is 13.6 electron volts. Now, Mariam, you will answer me. If I have to take this electron, okay, Mariam, I have to take this electron and I have to take it away from the nucleus to infinity. I have to take it away from the nucleus till infinity. Then tell me, how much energy should I be putting in the electron to get it away from the nucleus, from the influence of the nucleus?
We'll put positive energy.
We will put positive energy. And how much? If I want to take an electron away from the first orbit of hydrogen, then I have to put that much amount of energy, na? The amount of energy which the nucleus is applying to pull the electron, I have to apply the same kind of energy, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So that is called as the ionization enthalpy, ionization energy, okay? It is known as ionization energy. I hope you guys are done, right? You guys are done?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please write two more terms. Grounds. Okay, let me first. Okay, can you calculate the questions? Calculate the energy of electron. Hydrogen atom in following shells. Calculate for these three now. Then we will see the answers in electron volts, okay? Following shells in electron volts. Then we will derive a conclusion from the answers that you will get. Okay. So please solve this. It's very easy. Okay. Simple calculations. You can keep the calculated till decimal points. Okay. If you get decimal point, that will be good. it for the first one, Mariam. No, Ikra. The formula is this, Ikra, okay?
Okay, sir.
Z square upon n square. Z is equal to atomic number. N is the shell number. Yes, the one correct for the first one. Samaira, no, you did some mistake in typing. After the decimal point is, seems fine, but before the decimal point, the number seems a bit less. Can you try once more and tell me? But first, check the answer that you have sent. Yes, Mariam, correct for the C1 also. So for the first one, sorry. Yes, Samira, now it is correct. For the second shell, you will get the answer as -3.4 electron volt. Okay, so calculate for the third one. Please remember that these are squares. Yes, yes, Samira, very good, correct. Yes, correct, Safwan, very good. Ikra, are you having some trouble?
No, sir, I finished.
Okay, you finished. So you're typing now, okay. So it'll be -1.51. And for the fourth one, it will be -0.85. Now let me also put in here the first one, the first shell. Just say this is zero. First 13.6 electron volt. What I am doing, I am calculating the difference between first and second. So whenever you are calculating the difference, now the difference is always positive. Okay, subtraction can be negative, but difference, if I say what is the difference between this and this, we'll just say that, for example, what is the difference between 7 and 9? That will be 2. The difference is of 2. What is the difference between 9 and 7? That will be also 2. Okay, so the difference between the first and second is of 10.2 electron volt. For the second and third one is 1.89 electron volt. and then for 0.85 to 0.6 is. Okay, now can you see that the difference of energy is getting smaller and smaller?
Yes, sir.
Yes, the difference. So please remember this. Okay, I will use this information in E block elements of 12th standard. As we now, please, this is very important conclusion is that as the shell number increases, the difference in energy of the difference in energy of subsequent shells decreases. You can remember it like this, okay? As shell number increases, energy gaps decreases, okay? As the shell number increases, energy gap decreases, okay? Energy gap decreases. Please write this. Let me know when you're done.
Done, sir.
Done, sir. Done.
I want to draw the energy level diagram of the... Yeah, yeah, sure.
Done, sir.
Done. We want to draw the energy level diagram of orbits of hydrogen. So this is energy. You have the first orbit here. Let us say you have the second orbit here, okay? So the second orbit. Then the third orbit will be a bit closer to you. Now the difference will be a bit less. Then for fourth, it will be even less. For fifth, it will be even less. Correct? Yeah. Now the first is known as, this is known as ground state. What is ground state? Lowest possible energy state. So, okay, this is the first, this is second, third, fourth, and fifth. Now, anything above this, okay, anything above the ground state, it is known as excited state. Known as excited state. So, anything other than the first shell, it is the excited state. And since the shell number two, the N2, the shell number two, the orbit number two is the first excited state, right? It is the first one among the excited state. It's known as first excited state. Third is known as second excited state. Fourth is the third excited state. The fifth one is fourth excited state. Please copy this. Let me know if you're done. You can also say N1 here. This is N2. N3, N4, N5. That is the principal quantum number N, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the shell number.
Done, sir.
Is anyone still writing?
No, sir.
No? Okay, everyone is done. All right. Calculate the energy. Rick, go ahead. Calculate the energy required to take electron from the first shell of hydrogen. Infinite. Okay. So how will we solve this? Let's solve this. Whenever you have some transition taking place, okay, electron from first shell to second shell or third shell, fourth shell, up to infinity, anything is there, you will always write the initial state. What is the initial? And then you will write the final. What is the final? So initial is what? Where is the electron initially, Mariam?
The ground state.
Yeah, it is in the first shell. Na? See, we are, yes. In, according to the question you have to see, okay, calculate the energy required to take electron from the first shell. The initial is the first shell. The final is the infinite. Okay, final is infinite. So whenever you have to calculate the energy required, so you will write like this, energy required. Change of energy is what? Change of energy is final minus initial always. Okay, so final minus initial. So finally, the electron is in E infinity. Initially, electron is in the first orbit. Let me write the formula again. En is equal to minus 13.6 z square upon n square electron volts. Okay, so we'll put the n whatever it is there. So if I put n as infinity, E will become zero. If I put n as infinity, E will become zero. This is zero minus E1 is minus 13.6 z for hydrogen is 1 square upon 1 square, that is n is also 1, right? So we'll get this in electron volts. Now as you can see that this negative and this negative will become positive here, and you will get the answer 13.6 electron volt. And this is exactly what I asked initially, that if I have electron in the first shell, how much energy will be required? So 13.6 electron in positive, right? This positive sign, what it is denoting? It is denoting that we are giving the energy, okay? So energy is not released. Energy is absorbed by the electron, and then electron is going from the first orbit to the infinity. Did everyone understand this? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So please copy this.
Done, sir.
Okay. Is there anyone who is still writing?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Very good. Complete this. Let me know if you're done. Then we will do a few questions here. Done, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So always you have to do final minus initial. Final minus initial. Okay. But before that, let us calculate one more thing. So whenever you take something from the ground state and you take it till the infinity, it is known as ionization enthalpy. Okay. It is known as ionization enthalpy. So let us calculate the right like this. Calculate the energy required. By electron in first shell of helium positive. Okay, now why am I writing helium positive? Because we are studying the Bohr model, and Bohr model is only applicable to single electron system. Now helium has two electron, helium positive will have only one electron. That is why we'll apply whatever we have got the result from the we have got the result from the Bohr model, we will apply them only to the single electron system. So calculate the energy required by electron in the first shell of helium, positive, to take it to infinity or infinite. Okay, so please remember this, the formula is equal to En is equal to minus 13.6. You have Z square upon N square. Please remember this, okay? This is number of protons, the atomic number, this is the shell number, and you will get the answer in electron volts. So please calculate this. But before you have initial and final stages, Ekara, tell me what is the initial stage here? What is the initial shell? Where is the electron initially? Yes, Ekara?
Ground state.
Are bhai, ground, which shell?
First shell.
Yeah, tell me like this, na? First shell. And we are taking it to infinity, right? So energy will be equal to final minus initial, that is energy at infinity minus energy at the initial stage, which is n is equal to 1. Okay, so you will apply this formula. Let us see who get this fastest. Let us see this.
We have done very similar question just before.
Now, Samira, now calculate. Samira, did you calculate? No, na? Yes, Samira?
Yes, sir.
Did you calculate?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then calculate once more. And keep in mind what in the formula, what is the meaning of Z? What is the meaning of N? Okay? Keep that in mind. No. No, Mariam. Yes. Ikra, you just went wrong with the sign, but everything else is correct.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so please say rookie mistake. E infinity will be zero minus, so it'll be minus 13.6. Now tell me, Samira, what do I have right here? Z is equal to how much, Samira?
Sir, I wrote 1.
But how much it is? Why did you write 1? Atomic no, number, na?
Sir, it is HC plus, right? So like 2 minus.
2 minus? What 2 minus?
2 minus.
Aray, protons bina nikalte hain hum log. We only take out the electrons. We cannot take out the protons. If anything has only one proton, that means it is hydrogen. If something has two protons, that means it is helium. So the number of proton is the identity. You cannot change the identity of any atom. Okay. If it is element helium, it will always have two protons. So please, rookie mistake here. Okay. So this is Z. Z is 2 square. What is N here? Samira, what will be N?
1, sir.
1. Electron volts. So this will be equal to, this is 2. This will be positive. Okay, Ekra, you got the mistake. This negative, negative will become positive. So this will be 4 into 13.6 electron volt. Okay. So as you can see that if we increase the charge, then it is much more difficult. We have to put 4 times more energy, right? If the proton number has increased by only 1 unit, then we need 4 times more energy. Please write this, then we will do the next question. Yeah.
Done, sir.
Done, sir.
Okay. So an electron has made transition from the sixth excited state to the second excited state. Okay, so from the sixth excited state to second excited state, it has traveled, it has jumped off. Then which of the following represents the transition correctly? So your option A is please choose the correct one. N7 means from 7th to 4th, 5th to 3rd orbit, 7th to 3rd orbit, 6th to 2nd orbit. From the 6th excited state to 2nd excited state. अरे किसी को नहीं आ रहा है क्या? Why are you guys thinking so much? Why are you guys taking so much time? Please look in your notes ना. We have drawn the excited state, ground state, and the energy levels also. The shell number. Please look at there. Please look there and tell me. Yes, Ekra, you are right. One. No, Mariam. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the ground state. Second is the first excited state. Right? So if you have got the excited state and you want to find the orbit number, you want to find the shell number, then what you have to do? You have to do the excited state, whatever the excited state is, plus one. So it is 6 excited state, plus one will be. This is the 7th orbit. Okay, this is the 7th orbit because it is 6 excited states. So this is 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 7th orbit will be the 6th excited state. And 2nd excited state will be the N3 3rd. So this is C is correct. Samaira and Mariam, did you get it? Why C is correct now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Ikra. Okay, Ikra gave the right answer. Samaira and Mariam got D. Okay. You have written the question. Can I move on?
Yes, sir.
Okay. calculate the energy required. For an electron. To make transition from. Excited state to the ground state. Yes, so Mariam, you will tell me the initial stage and the final stage. What is the initial stage?
Fifth.
What is the initial stage, Mariam?
Sixth shell.
Yeah, sixth shell. So n is equal to 6 and final is n is equal to 1, right?
Yes,
sir. So now you can apply the formula En is equal to minus 13.6 Z square upon N square electron volts, and you can get the answer. Okay. So please calculate this. Tell me the answer.
So we have to do a final minus initial.
Yeah, exactly. Same thing.
Then, sir, the atomic mass.
Why do you need the atomic mass? Is it for Z?
Yes,
oh, sorry.
Sir.
Yeah, atomic mass, it is atomic number. Sorry. Ground state of, good question, hydrogen atom. You can take the minus 13.6 common, okay? Don't solve all those things. Take minus 13.6 common, and then you have to just solve for the 1 by 6 square minus 1. That will make it easy. unless so just calculate this and tell me. Yes, correct. This, what is your sign? Yeah, positive, correct. Okay, plus 13.2. Okay, you can just approximate to 13.2. You will have to give the electron 13.2 electron volts of energy to take it from the first shell to the sixth shell, to the first shell to the sixth shell. Okay. And also do what we have learned till now. The conclusion is that we have a proton here, we have different shells here, one, two, three, four, and five. We saw that if I take an electron and I have to put it from the lower to the higher shell, from lower to higher shell, I have to give energy, okay. Now, similarly, if anything, any electron is in higher state and it is falling back to the lower level, it will be giving out energy or releasing energy. Now, when the energy is released, if energy is there, that means it should have, it should follow the Planck's formula E is equal to h nu. That means every bit of energy will be associated with some frequency and some lambda, right? Some frequency and the wavelength, Now, when this wavelength and frequency, this lie in the visible region, then only we see that lights, then only we see those spectral lines, okay? Okay, let us do one thing. Whenever you have energy that will be associated with some lambda and frequency, that means all these lambda and frequency, if they are in the visible region, then we can see those transition, right? We can see those transition. And that was happening in the hydrogen lamp that we saw in that video, right? In that video, what do we see? We see that there is some hydrogen in the glass tube, okay? There is H2 in the glass tube. Now, when voltage is applied in this H2 and voltage is applied, what happens? Hydrogen gets excited. Now, what does it mean that hydrogen gets excited? Hydrogen proton will not get, never get excited. What will it get excited? The electrons will get excited to higher levels. Right? So what is happening always in that discharge tube is that positive charge, you have different electrons. Now, when voltage is applied, electron is going to the higher level. Then it is again jumping back. Then electrons, maybe electron can jump back from the higher level to second level to third level, many levels, right? Now, for each level, you will get some kind of wave. Now, if that wave lies in the visible region, and always remember, it will have some frequency, a particular frequency, and a particular frequency will give you a particular color of light. You will not get a spectrum of light. Because as you know that only some fixed value of orbits are there. There is not continuous orbit. For example, if I say energy, I can say that now. See, there is a jump. Always there is a jump. You have calculated the energies of first, second, third, and fourth. Now see, the energy can be either -13.6, -3.4, -1.51, or -0.85. There cannot be any energy in the hydrogen atom between 0.85 and -1.51. There cannot be any energy between -1.5 to -3.4. That means there can be no frequency also. Now that corresponds to those particular energies. That is why we get some separate lines with gaps, and we don't get the complete spectrum. So we will write a spectrum of hydrogen atom in this class, but for now you can write that since each orbital, since each orbit is associated with energy, we can say that the electron should also have frequency and wavelength. Now, if you can remember properly, it started with the photoelectric effect. In that photoelectric effect, one wave was emitting out one electron. This was giving out the particle nature of electron. From this photoelectric effect, we made the Bohr model. Bohr got the idea, and Bohr made the Bohr model. And from the Bohr model, we got the idea that orbit, that electrons in orbit have energy. If they are having some kind of energy, that means they should be associated with some wavelength and frequency. And if there is wavelength and frequency, that means electron is a wave. Now, this is the birth of the wave and particle duality of nature. Wave and particle nature of all matters, not only electrons. De Broglie will come and he will say that not only electrons, everything is wave and everything is particle simultaneously. Now, what behavior is dominant is how you are going, what type of environment you are giving it. If you are giving anything, an environment in which it should behave like particles, then it will give you particle behavior. If you are giving an environment in which an object is going to show wave nature, then you will get the wave behavior of the particle. Okay, so it only depends on the environment that you are providing, whether it is for particle or whether it's for wave. But otherwise, everything is a particle and everything is a wave simultaneously. This is the wave particle duality of matter. So please write the last point. Since each orbit is associated with energy, we can say that electrons should also have frequency and wavelength, right? From here, we will start the de Broglie hypothesis. And before that, we will look at the spectrum of hydrogen. Then we will write those things. That Lyman series, Balmer series, Pasch series, you must have seen that in NCERT. So we will understand those first, then we will write the de Broglie hypothesis, okay?
Yes, sir.
So are you done copying this? Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes? Okay. So then we should stop here. We will meet. One more thing. We will meet on when? We'll meet on what date? Next, we will meet on? When will we meet next?
Wednesday.
Thank you for remembering that. Next class. Wednesday. Okay, next class is on Wednesday. But you have test on Monday. You have test on Sunday, right? You receive tests on Sundays? Yes or no? No one is speaking. You don't get... You have never got a test on Sunday from LearningView? Are you saying yes or no at least? No, Mariam?
Sir, no.
No.
Yes, sir, we got.
Are you registered in the platform? You have gotten a test? Okay, Mariam, are you registered in the app or the web platform anywhere?
Yes, sir.
So if you go there and check now, then you will see that you have tests and those tests are generally uploaded on Sundays. And what about assignments? You guys get assignments?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.